34 okay. degrees.
Yes, yes, 34?
Today's weather.
What?
What? Yeah, 34 apparently. Degrees?
Yeah. Mid to high 30s?
No, I saw like 40.
No, it's not 40. It is not 40. 40 in it's 100% 30. It's 35 right now.
In your neighborhood.
Maybe it will go up to... No, there's no way it'll get hotter. Yeah. Hotter. What's the degrees in Fahrenheit?
It's a half.
100
it'll peak at 37.
So. 111, maybe?
Damn.
As a borderline guess. That's I'm trying to remember how hot Phoenix, Arizona is. Because that's the Fahrenheit temperatures I always hear for the weather there.
Hot enough to cause a phoenix to rise from the ashes.
What ashes, you might ask? The ashes of the dead.
The ashes of dead. Democracy, bro. Because democracy is dead.
Would you want to be reborn as a phoenix?
No, because I've watched X-Men. Oh. And saw what happened to the phoenix, bro. Okay. It wasn't
the
good.
Phoenix pose?
Yeah.
Hey, it makes you stronger.
But it blew up. Better.
So does Nutrigrain.
Didn't what?
The Phoenix lady blew up.
I think that was unrelated. I can't remember what happened. Like in the Dark Phoenix movie? Or the X-Men 3?
Whichever movie but the Phoenix.
Because they did that twice in the movies. They did X3. Yeah. And then they did Dark Phoenix.
Did the Phoenix blow up in both movies?
I can't remember, honestly. Because they were both bad movies. But I'll tell you one thing, you know, Echo gets the Phoenix Force at one point.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Kinda, yeah.
In the comics. Sure.
Anyway, welcome back, everyone, to another episode of the podcast.
Oh, wow. Democracy is dead.
Democracy is dead. I'm your host, Deo Zephros. To my left is...
Welcome back to Democracy is Dead. I'm your host, SNL. Shenzi, Sunny, whatever.
And I'm Jack. And not to get political, but you want to talk about the Friendly Geordies thing? I feel like it's pretty big news.
Yeah.
So, I'll be informed.
Yeah. You know, you're familiar with Friendly Jordan.
I know the guy.
Indeed. Mr. Shanks.
YouTube political commentator man.
And journalist.
Political commentator. Yeah. I want to see a political commentator.
He's kind of more than a political commentator now, because he's done like more like...
Yes.
I don't think
he likes to call himself a journalist.
Yeah, but he is. He's by definition a journalist. He's an investigative journalist.
Because he hates journalists.
I'd like to see...
He is what journalism should strive to be.
Yeah.
I would love to see football commentators doing live commentary on like parliamentary... The debates.
Like on the question time or something?
Yeah, I think so, right?
Pete Dunne comes up to the stand. He first welcomes the Mr. Speaker.
Then Albo stands up and he slaps him across the face.
Slaps him across the field.
10 points to Gryffindor.
10 points
He hits
Gryffindor.
Him with that Italian backhand.
The five-finger Sicilian style.
Yeah.
That's what I call it.
For sure. But so Friendly Geordies, he does a lot of this investigative journalism, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. One of the things he tackles is the corruption in the New South Wales government and potential, particularly the Liberals.
They have been in for the last 10 or so years until Chris Minns came in last year as the new Labour state government.
Yeah. And their potential ties, their alleged ties,
allegedly,
to the criminal underworld of Sydney.
Yes. So he made an investigative video a few months back about this issue relating to some crime families around Sydney and their involvement with certain members of parliament.
And he name drops, and he has evidence that, like, he does proper journalism, you know. Builds up a bit of a case.
Yeah.
An interesting case that involved, like, there was kidnapping. Alleged kidnapping, alleged potential murder, and just alleged white collar crime, I guess.
Oh, yeah.
Or is it white collar crime or is it just regular crime?
It's a pretty rough crime, you know. But the white collar part is in the politicians,
and in, like, the business.
The business.
They have, like, a. thing called coronation construction or something.
Yeah, a lot of this involves property development within Sydney.
Yeah.
Because, you know, there is a undisclosed, you could say, a bit of a mafia around
construction. It's like Wilson Fisk in And
you know, there's a lot of money in construction. Even Tony Soprano delves into construction a bit, you know.
Yeah.
So it's a well-known business for good money making.
Yeah. Actually, he's kind of like Karen Page in The Daredevil
show. Yeah, Karen.
Karen, yeah.
Friendly Karen.
But essentially, a few months ago, I think we did cover this part that you might remember. The house got firebombed.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So recently, I believe it was about a month ago, they figured out who, a potential suspect, and they arrested this suspect. And apparently it was one of the people, or like strongly linked with one of the people that he mentioned in that video. And so then Mr. Geordies has received more threats and stuff to take the video down. And so, because, you know, it seems like a pretty legit threat, because his house got firebombed and because of all the stuff he talks about in that video to do with, you know, making people disappear and all that sort of shit, you know, real sketchy crime shit.
That just proves that this video is very much to the, what do you call it? Seems like they're saying the truth if these guys are angry about it, you know.
Yeah, so he complied and made a video, like a short like statement video, taking down that investigative video. And I don't know what he's gonna do with the future of his channel as of now, but like, he has taken a couple months break, I think.
Yes, I think
so. Yeah, but I guess the interesting thing is, I can't remember what there's actually a term for this, kind of something effect, where because he took that video down, everyone started re-uploading the video, and then more people are seeing it.
Right.
That's the, so that's kind of it's kind of, how do they not see that coming though? That's like,
because they're too old school. Yeah, you know? It's like school. If you have an article in the papers, you can just take the papers, you know. But in the internet age,
yeah,
you can't take that down.
Yeah, it's kind of silly goober behavior.
Mm-hmm.
And also mentioned with that firebombing thing, they got it wrong and firebombed his neighbor's house the first time. And then went whoops, and then did it again to his actual house.
Yeah, damn.
So it's like, yeah.
Thorough.
Oh, also potential links to a former deputy state leader, Mr. Barilaro.
Allegedly.
Allegedly.
Hmm. Well, yeah.
Because he's a Mamma Mia man.
Here we go again.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's see a movie.
But I guess
that no one will fund.
Check out that coronation video, because it's there are so many re-uploads.
Oh yeah. But you know, do you know about the?
But obviously, we don't agree with. I mean, we don't. We stand in full support of the. Don't come at us, gangs of Sydney.
We're not saying anything.
It's all alleged. Yeah.
Yeah, we're not trying to state anything.
We're not worth your three-hour drive or plane ticket.
Yeah, and if you mess with us, we'll call up the Dan Andrews. You can't mess with Dan Andrews.
We'll call up the North Macedonian government or something. That's where our YouTube channel is based.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
Macedonia. Actually.
Mm-hmm.
Shut the fuck up, nerd. I'm gonna firebomb your house.
Actually,
yeah, what if they just put a firebomb this house because he's there, like, shut up, nerd, you did your research.
Yeah.
Wish that happened to me in school.
Damn.
You want your school
bombed? I did my research.
Oh.
Teacher comes on my house. How dare you do the research? Firebombs.
That's crazy.
That would be awesome, bro. You know, finally some acknowledgement for your hard work.
I know, and I get a nice little surprise.
A warm,
hot and spicy.
Do you know about the 80s? Labour government in New South Wales, they had some big cases. Not big cases.
Well, the 80s were a good time. Yeah.
They had a lot of controversy with their ties with the
mafia government at the time.
It was the Labour government, but in the 80s. Because, like, the guy was a cool cool guy. He let the crime slide, so he gets a bit of investment properties in his pocket, you know.
Damn. I mean, the '80s were a time, you know.
Yeah.
That's where all the cool crime was.
It was.
Yeah.
But now all you get is these property developers like taxing you on your rent, making you pay overpriced rent, and I guess for the property itself for shit development. Because that's how they make money. Because Australia is a real estate heaven where the bubble never bursts, because it never will, because there's too many people who don't want it to burst.
In other real estate news, it's completely kind of randomly yes. related, but if we're off with that topic, it's a funny thing that I've been not researching, but noticing, you know, Docklands?
Yes,
Docklands. Yeah, Docklands is like fuck because nobody lives in Docklands. It's all Airbnbs. So the government's trying to like. Well, I mean, it's not really.
People who come to the city or whatever. Who buy up these apartments and not live in them.
Yeah, I don't know. But Costco is moving from Docklands now.
Damn, where they moving?
To some other suburb, I don't know.
Moving to a...
And they're planning to, like, completely build up Marvel Stadium into, like, this massive place.
At where Costco was?
No, Marvel Stadium to attract people to Docklands.
Oh.
I don't think that'll really... Will that fix the issue? I don't know.
So, I mean, would people just move to Docklands to go to Marvel Stadium? That doesn't seem like very
Unless they're building housing on top
of Marvel apartments Stadium? On top of Marvel Stadium.
You go try to go to sleep and it's just the AFL siren.
Yeah.
Sorry, neighbors.
That'd be great.
Yeah, I'm not really sure what exactly the development is, but
that was very loud. I'm sorry.
It's funny. No one complained. I mean, they should make the apartments cheaper, then people move
in. So, yeah, that's why my thoughts. So I'm like, what if they make the apartments cheaper, then I swoop in?
Yeah, then I would.
Then I would get, that's where I would buy my first property. But, think about that. That's the strap. So I'm gonna keep my eye on that area for a bit.
See, what if we just firebomb the apartments so the prices go down?
Okay, so you want to know a really interesting thing. I didn't even know this because I was researching crime in Docklands because there was a stabbing outside my work and we had to go into a lockdown. So I was just like, oh, is it going to appear on the news, right? So I was looking at the thing, but apparently there's been a string of arsons that are gang related in Docklands.
Oh, is this another real estate mob hit?
This is like a few months ago, I think.
Okay. They're trying to buy off.
You trying to think about any gang ties you have?
You can see on his arm, he has some gang affiliation there.
Yeah, what does your tattoo say?
Monkey.
He's from the monkey gang, bro.
It literally says monkey.
Yo. You know, I tried to look for monkey ears, but I could not find any. Mm. I went to Brunswick, went to like every costume store, nothing.
Mm.
So I guess I'm just going to use my, I'm doing a dress up as Arthur from the show Arthur.
Yes.
And it was more like, I just need like brown ears, right? I literally couldn't find any. So I have like black mouse ears, like Mickey Mouse type. Mm. Or I might just use I just might have my own actual ears because I'm more monkey than
man. You know how they put headphones on in Arthur? They have to like put headphones like, and then it's just like a loop on top of their head because that's where their ears are.
Yeah. And that's where you get the funny meme.
Exactly.
Yeah. Anyway.
How does the Arthur theme song go again?
I never watched Arthur.
We can listen to it after.
After.
Right. Let's talk about some stuff that I watched this week.
Radio.
Okay. Let me consult the trusty phone.
Radio.
Now, I have watched the movie that will cover next week, Argyle.
Mm.
But I won't tell you if I liked it or not. Do you already know, though? Because I was talking about it at the gym.
Oh, yeah.
But I did watch it. What else did I watch? Oh, I finished Ted Lasso season 3. Pretty decent. I don't think it was as strong of a finale as I would hope. But still a good show. Still a great show. Did I talk about Bottoms last week?
Bottoms?
No. Well, I watched this movie Bottoms. if you're not familiar with this film,
in that movie.
It came out last year, and it's like Fight Club.
But for women.
But with, yeah, with women in college.
I think you might have talked about it.
Yeah, it's such an incredibly funny movie. Like, actually so good. You guys should watch it, I reckon. You probably dig it. It's like, they start a fight club. Like, it was meant to be like a self-defense club to protect women, but they just wanted to fight each other. And it's a whole thing. And it gets, like, super wacky and, like, surrealist. Like, people just get killed, but it's, like, for fun. And it's like, it's a wacky comedy, and it's like actually got really good writing, and the jokes like mostly constantly land, and it's like pretty good. Good movie.
Seems good.
I watched Mr. and Mrs. Smith, the movie, which we'll cover the TV show next week. I think the movie is fine, like genuinely just like a 5 out of 10 average movie. It's the movie that you guys might know is famous because it's the affair of Brad Pitt and Angelina Jolie.
Huh.
Where they formed Brangelina or whatever it was. I don't know. They're divorced now. Who gives a shit?
Damn.
But that was a big thing, right? That's why that movie is famous. It's the premise is kind of fun. It's like a couple of assassins, and then one day they realize they have to the target is each other, and they have to like assassinate each other. This is domestic violence for the entire movie.
Domestic
violence. But I think it gets like too wacky and like stuff. Whereas the TV show, I'm only halfway through and we'll cover it next week. I think the TV show is fantastic. Like, it's actually so fucking good. And I was like, this show seems very familiar tonally, I think, to Atlanta, with like how it's a bit of a satire and stuff.
Okay.
Like rich people and stuff like that. And it's from the director of Atlanta, so that makes sense. Donald Glover produced, like, it's the gang.
Yeah.
And I think the TV show is really good so far, and we'll cover that more.
Cool.
But that's the stuff. And I've still been, playing The Last of Us Part 2, trying to get it done before the review, but it's like 24 hours long. That's and I play like an hour a day because I don't have much time.
Oh, yeah.
An hour every 2 days, maybe, actually.
24 hours. How do I get it done
quickly?
Do a speed run.
I've been trying. I'm like, I'm not going to bother looting houses. I'm thinking maybe to make it more worth my time, instead of doing a regular review, I can do more of a video essay. But I don't really know if I have any interesting things to say about it. Like, what? I don't know. What do you guys know about The Last of Us Part 2? That's not like story elements. I just mean the conversation around it. Huh?
The conversation around it.
Yeah.
Well, I guess what can be said has been said, I suppose.
Yeah, I'm not super familiar because I avoided the conversation. So I'm like, what was the controversy?
It's been too long, I've forgotten.
Well, the initial controversy was just people hate women.
Yeah. Thing that happens at the start.
Yeah.
But we can talk spoilers, right? Like, it's been out for ages.
Yeah.
I don't. Maybe some people are playing the remaster now. I don't know.
Yeah.
Like me, but like Joel dies. That's like kind of. I knew that was a big thing. If that's it, I don't know. I'll play it, see how it goes. But I guess I gotta start. Right, I might write a script as I play. I don't know. We'll see. Mm. Just to save time. So far, I'm digging it though. I didn't really. Oh, here's a hot. Wait, this is a hot take I've given on every episode of the show. But I don't really give that much of a shit about The Last of Us.
Yes,
that's why I like. I watched the TV show, and I'm like. Oh, it's good, and like I think it's a good representation of the game, but like I don't really care that much about the game, and I also don't care that much about the TV show in the same sort of level. Like,
yeah,
that's why people who love the game probably like the TV show as well because it's like the same, but like I just it's zombie shit. It's just like it's every fucking zombie story.
I guess the initial appeal of the original game is like it was a good looking game at the time. And it played all right with a good story. So it was like a good game.
Yeah. It's just that I've seen playing it when I played it. It's just that story I've seen before. Floated. Yeah. It's like.
Because it's very much based around. It's the Mandalorian, media but like.
Yeah. And it's the Walking Dead as well with like But The Last of Us Part 2, it's kind of interesting because it's like. It's sort of like John Wick, but in the Last of Us universe because it's like a big revenge. Thing.
Yeah.
And I guess the interesting narrative device is like they kill off Joel really early, and you as the audience are pretty angry, so you channel that into the rage of the character, right?
Yeah, yeah.
And I think, I don't know, there are elements that I feel like could have made it more satisfying in that way, but like, I haven't finished the story, I don't know how it's gonna end or whatnot. But yeah. But all I know is people were very angry at that Joel died.
Cause people like Joey.
Yeah.
They used him as a plot device instead.
I mean, the gameplay and stuff in Last of Us Part 2, that the thing I can 100% say, and I don't really see how anyone would argue different, is the gameplay in Part 2 is much, much better than Part 1.
Okay.
Like, they decide to do a lot more stealth.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you get a lot more tools of stealth. You get to, like, they do a feature of you can go prone, so you can lie in grass and shit like that and scurry around. Give you new tools and stuff to work with that. And they've taken the Uncharted 4 approach to do, like, these small open worlds. So you can approach things in either stealth or loud or whatever. Sometimes I just run through the level, dodging bullets and shit. Because nobody has really good guns. It's just like, they're just like pistols that fire, and then you have to wait and then fire again. Yeah. And I'm just like, I can outrun them all and make it to the end of the level.
Gotta go fast.
But yeah. Also, I take my horse to the old town.
And ride.
Till I can't go home. Yeah.
But yeah, genuinely, I think it's a good game so far. We'll see how it goes.
Boom, chicka, boom, boom.
All right. Is there anything else that you guys wanted to talk about before we do our funny little game?
Have you heard Kojima's new thing?
Which new thing? Because there's a couple. Oh, yeah, we can talk about the state of play, right?
Yeah.
So we've got the trailer for Death Stranding 2. It was like a 10-minute long cinematic.
I haven't watched it, but yeah.
It looks really interesting.
Faces.
And I'll probably pre-order because I love the first game so much. Like, that game was incredible. Try to play that game again and do the director's cut. I couldn't though. I think it was just like a one and done thing. I don't think I can play it again. Just because it's just like so long and I guess tedious, but like, fuck. I did enjoy it though.
Kojima
announced, like, it's kind of unclear what it is, but I guess it's like a game, but it's being developed in a movie studio. Which, you know that theory about how, well, I mean, it's not really a theory, it's kind of proven that Kojima doesn't like making video games.
He wants to make
a movie. He just wants to make movies.
But he doesn't want to make a movie.
Well, I think he probably does want to make a movie, but he just ended up being like pigeonholed into game design.
Well, I mean, he's his own boss now, so he can just make a movie.
Yeah, which is what he's pretty much doing.
But in a video game.
Well, he's making the Death Stranding movie with A24.
Oh, true.
That got announced like a few months ago.
So he is making movies.
Yeah. Yeah, I think he generally doesn't like making games anymore.
But well, the new thing he announced is apparently a stealth type beat.
But
the movie.
Yeah, it's like an espionage thing.
It's going back to Metal Gear roots, but without being Metal Gear.
Yeah. We got the trailer for Silent Hill 2, the Konami game without Kojima. Wait, Silent Hill's not a Kojima game, what am I saying?
Nah.
Yeah, Silent Hill 2. I've downloaded the Silent Hill little playable teaser thing that they released.
Little demo.
I need to find time because I might stream that on my Twitch.
Oh yeah.
If it's the one that I can run through in like one sitting, then I'll do that. Maybe I could upload it to the channel. I don't know.
Do live review, live reaction. Review.
Sure. Yeah, when will I have time? One day.
One day. Someday. Before the game comes out.
Yeah, before. Oh, I'm still deciding what game I should be playing for February, but I haven't finished Last of Us yet. But it's looking like I'm probably going to skip Suicide Squad because it's not getting good reviews. It might be Skull and Bones, or I might just play Persona 3.
Oh, you're getting into Personas.
Yeah, because it just came out, and I'm like, that's a good, I've heard it's a good starting point for the series, right? 3? Is it the best? It is
kind of the start of the modern Persona.
Yeah. I'm not super interested in the old one. I've looked at the stuff, and I've been like...
Apparently the remaster is going pretty good, but people are complaining about the music because they changed the singer.
Yeah. Well, they also like cut a lot of content, right?
Yeah, I think so. Yeah. But haven't delved into it.
But you know what? If it's approachable for a new person, that's fine. And then I'll eventually play 4 and 5. Yeah. If I like 3, right?
Well, it's basically Persona 3 in the Persona 5 engine.
Yeah.
Yeah. Should be more playable, approachable.
The new Yakuza game drop.
Oh, yeah, yeah, well. Yeah.
I've heard it is not good or good or okay. It is Yakuza one of those
fans
options.
Seems to like it because they're Yakuza fans.
I was listening to a podcast last night and listening to Yakuza fans talk about me like the start of the game, the first 3 hours are incredibly dull.
Mm.
But I don't know.
I haven't played the RPG.
People don't like the voice actor for Kiryu in the English dub, though. Which is something we covered, I think, because it's Yong-ye who does the voice.
I see. Yeah.
But people don't seem to enjoy his performance. Yeah, it sucks because he's like a fan, right?
Japanese.
Yeah. Uh-huh. I should get back into Yakuza, but I guess the Yakuza thing is like the games go for ages, and like once you get out of it and you want to get back in, it's like, wait, what happened?
Well, that's why you go chronological order.
Yeah, I'm playing from Yakuza Zero, yeah.
Oh, but you mean then, like when my you game stop got deleted, in the middle of the game.
Yeah. My game got deleted because of bloody PlayStation Plus or whatever. I haven't even renewed my subscription because I can't access anything with my fucking wallet was stolen.
You got nicked back.
Yeah. Do I talk about that on the podcast?
You can voice your frustration.
Motherfucker stole my wallet. If you're listening to this, Maddie stole my wallet.
Or a person.
Yeah, we don't want to box you into any gender norms.
Human who stole my wallet?
I could be an animal.
You fucking dog gun who stole my wallet? I'm
dog.
I'm going to track you down like Ellie in The Last of Us Part 2. I'm going to kill you.
See, he already
I don't know how The Last of Us Part 2 ends, so if Ellie doesn't kill Abby, then this analogy won't work.
A dog ate my homework.
I'm going to kill you like John Wick killed that man who killed his dog. Yes. Anyway, yeah, that was that. I don't remember what else came out of State of Play. Actually, I can look that up. God, PlayStation.
God. PlayStation.
PlayStation. Has PlayStation fallen off?
You know, a funny thing I was thinking about the other day, I was thinking about, like, what was a good year for movies? This is unrelated. But I just remember that one year that we got, I think it was 2021, I think. But we had, like, a bunch of, like, really good, like, period drama.
Yeah.
Which we had, like, Trials of Chicago 7. Oh, the Judas and the Black Messiah, and that one it was like Malcolm X and stuff where they're meeting at the hotel or something. I don't know, that was a completely unrelated thing, but I was just thinking about what was it? That was a good year for period dramas. Nothing really. Mm. I think
Napoleon trends. Bonaparte.
Oh yeah, I guess.
Napoleon.
Oh yeah, Foam Stars has come in day one release to PlayStation Plus. So I guess maybe I checked that one out. Yeah.
Yeah.
Prince 3. Kojima stuff. Stellar Blade. Yeah, that's we know. The creator of Bioshock returns with Judas, that little horror game that looks pretty spooky, pretty Bioshock-like.
I need to play the OG Bioshock, because I've only played Infinite,
I haven't played any of them, but I do own two.
Oh, yeah.
We're getting Until Dawn remastered, coming to PC and PS5. Can finally play Until Dawn.
Does that game need a remaster, or is it just more platforms as well? I feel like that game has aged decently.
I think because it's... I mean, I don't know. The updated version introduces a new third-person camera, new like light stuff, which is because like shining a light into the dark. I think there's also some new content.
Ray tracing.
Yeah, I think I mean making the lighting and stuff better is always nice.
Yeah,
because we're getting Rise of the Ronin coming out on March 22nd. Helldivers 2 coming out. The Dragon's Dogma 2. And that's kind of it. Wasn't that exciting day to play, but the Kojima stuff, I guess. But that's probably like 5 years away.
Yeah.
All right. Shall we get into the...
The movies. I was copying Keemstar in my head.
All right. So Sunman wants to do a little something something.
Because we got nothing to do today. We don't really have anything to do today, do we?
Dry.
Do you watch The Dry?
Yeah.
Oh, did you?
Yeah.
Oh shit, let's talk about that a little bit.
Because I remember we only said we weren't going to
Did you watch both part one and part two?
But I sort of skimmed them.
I skimmed part one.
How did you skim part two?
I skimmed part one.
Oh, okay.
I watched
part
two. Yeah. But I didn't pay attention for part one. I just paid attention at the end.
Yeah, yeah. The projectionist. Yo, just skim through.
10 seconds, bro.
Yeah. But they're pretty, I feel like they're pretty cool Australian crime things, right?
I thought they were pretty good.
I feel like the second one you guys probably like because it's set in Victoria and you probably know a lot of the location stuff.
Mm.
You literally see the police headquarters in Dockland.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
The foresty areas.
Yeah, very familiar type forest area. Because I've been to some forest. I'm like, yeah, that's a forest. Yeah.
Forest.
Yeah. But yeah, you guys enjoyed?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That was
good. Well, yeah. I don't know.
He does.
It felt like a little tropey at times.
Yeah.
The fact that it's Australian.
Australian.
Maybe it's tropey in a way that only the main character figures everything out because he's smart.
He's literally a it's his job.
Yeah, but no one else could figure it out.
I guess
he's the only one who's, I figured it out.
Well, in the first one, he's the only one investigating it.
Yeah.
So that makes sense. In the second one, it's interesting because it's like the cops and stuff don't want to solve it. They're trying to do their own thing.
True, yeah.
So it's like, but also he's kind of also trying to do his own thing, I guess.
But the partner did nothing.
Yeah, I didn't. She was there.
Yeah, she was there.
She was there. But I think the first one's really cool because it's like, it really captures the isolation of like a small country town in rural Australia.
Yeah, and it was actually dry.
It was dry.
The second one's really wet.
So I think it's like all of the trilogy, like different types of Australia.
She called it the wet.
The dry, the wet, and the in between.
The in between, the maybe moist. Like the
The third movie, the moist.
Surely the third one's like in the at the beach or something. I don't know. What's the
get the dry salty. Sand, the wet water. Mm.
Yeah. It would be like Broadchurch.
Oh, I've got an idea for the third movie. The body of Harold Holt washes up on a beach.
Yo, that reminds me of the Haunted Pool movie. What was it, like the Harold Holt something?
Yeah, they mentioned.
Yeah, they mentioned Harold Holt in that movie. It was
like, it disappeared in a body of water, mate, just like Harold Holt.
No, it was like they named like a company or something, or a location like the Harold Holt something. Like maybe it was like the Harold Holt Hospital.
No, it was the school.
Harold Holt School.
And
that was fucking funny.
Near where I live, there's a Harold Holt swimming pool.
Yeah.
Funny.
That's pretty funny.
Fucking what? Yeah.
But anyway, point being, check out The Dry 2. It's in theaters. If you want to see, support the Australian film industry. That was the main reason I was getting you guys to watch it. Because, like, Australian movies, If you guys know any cool Australian movies that are dropping this year, let us know and we'll probably check it out.
Bluey the movie.
Mad Max Furiosa. That one's going to be pretty hype.
Mm.
I reckon that one has the potential to crack it into the top 10. Highest grossing movies of the year. I think Mad Max will do really well. Because the last one was Fury Road, and like Fury Road was incredible. Like, have you guys seen Fury Road?
I have not.
I still need to watch it.
It's like one of the defining action movies of probably all time.
Hmm.
It's insane, incredible movie.
All I remember was as a kid mainly. I think it was as a kid. When did it come out? Ages ago, right?
Mid-2010.
2016 maybe?
Okay, well.
Younger you, version
younger
of
me,
yourself.
And me and my sister were just shitting on it, calling it Furry Road.
Oh, you
I think
you
were just even go
you
watch
were
it.
You were what's the term? Projecting.
Furry-phobic.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Exactly. I mean, also detective stuff. I've been watching Case Closed.
Oh, that's such a good show. Yeah,
I know. Some people like, I know, I understand some people are like, there's not like a consistent storyline.
It's an episodal
thing. It's a sitcom.
What do you call that? Situational detective?
It's a procedural. That's what the term is.
Yeah. But, yeah. Because I watched it as a kid. It's just like I did with One Piece.
It's literally the equivalent of, you know, like those NCIS type shows.
Mm-hmm. Yes, that's it.
Which, fun fact, are literally like the most watched shows of all time. You know, all the weird ones you see in America, like on the TV?
Yeah.
Those are just the most watched shows of all time. Like, streaming shows don't come close to that, the numbers that those do. Because
they've been there much longer, no?
Maybe, but I guess they have avid fans.
And, yeah. Well, they've been there for a lot longer.
People love their Law and Order and whatnot. Yeah.
And they're still going, so they would be the longest, most watched show, probably.
I mean, call me a Zoomer. Call me a Zoomer. I'm like 100 episodes in, and I'm still in the year 1998. From when these episodes were released.
I don't remember like where I got up to in the manga and where I got up to anime. So I think Netflix had a weird thing where they didn't do all the anime.
No.
It was just like a collection of random episodes.
Right, yeah.
Because too much.
So but I got decently far into the manga. Like I've gotten past the point where the girl, the funny girl.
Which girl?
The one that's like coded, like is like an adult.
The scientist lady.
Yeah.
Who became girl.
Are you up to that?
No.
Are you watching the movies as well?
Not yet. I might just watch the series. I don't know when the movie's coming.
You should check out the movies. The movies are good.
Very good.
Yeah. They've also, I think they've got like a few crossover movies maybe, like Kaito Kid.
Yeah, well, Kaito Kid has always been part of the lore.
Did they have one?
He was my favorite character. Well, actually, no. Shinichi was still my favorite character, but yeah. But Keisuke is still my favorite anime / manga.
Fuck yeah.
Yeah.
Do they have a crossover with Lupin the Third?
Yes.
Maybe, yeah.
Yeah, something like that.
Yeah.
Yeah, I need to watch more.
Oh yeah, when I was a kid, I would go find Keisuke in the library and read that. Same. I went to Japan.
At the same library, also... I'm guessing, right?
No, it was back in Sydney. Like way before I even came to London.
Right. When I was your age, I was looking for the manga in my local library.
I'd go to Japan, be at like a little cafe, they have a few collection of some manga. I would read it. I can't understand any of the text. But I'd be
images.
I can imagine.
Right.
And yeah, it just really tapped into that. I know, it's a great show, I feel, especially for kids to like start getting into like mystery stuff. Like they do it, like they honestly do it really well. They're all really well written.
What's your thinking?
It like blew my mind when I came across like locked room mysteries. What the hell? How they? But the doors are locked. They can't. Can't do the murder. This is impossible.
Yeah.
I was like, yeah.
Good times. Good shit, guys. Good shit.
Anyway, shall we get on to? You want to explain what we're doing?
Rightio. So the game is pretty simple. Right.
The game's called Sunny's IMDb Funny Roulette.
So IMDb. Actually, I looked online, and then there was someone already coined IMDb Roulette for like a.
There's a different
because they can do like you can make like a page on IMDb, but it's just them saying, generate a random number on randomnumbergenerator.com, and then select a movie. And I'm like, okay.
And that's how you...
No, that's not how I did it. Here I've got a somewhat random IMDb movie from everybody's favorite reliable source of movie knowledge. And...
I mean, kind of the only thing with a lot of movie stuff.
Yeah. And these two don't know what it is.
Unless we do. What if,
will completely ruin this.
See, I have an insider... Some insider information from my mind.
I will lead these people through this, and for every fact that they get right about it, they will get a point.
Yay! This is like that Tom Scott game.
This is exactly like the Tom Scott game. Yeah. I will say it there.
It's okay. Now he's retiring.
He's retiring, so we can steal his ideas. No, I am not stealing Tom Scott's idea. This is movies. Not Wikipedia pages.
Exactly.
And this will probably not work as well, but we will see.
All right.
I've got two prepared. Maybe one. I got two for like runtime, or two for the fact that one of you might know.
Okay.
The Burbs.
This sounds really familiar, actually, but I don't know.
I figured.
I still
suburbs, burbs.
Yeah, it's something that said the suburbs. Yeah.
Well, he said suburbs, so he gets a point for that one.
Are you supposed to ask questions, or are we just spouting facts?
I mean, what do you think it's about? Let's start with when it was released.
All right.
Decade. I'm going to steal this from Tom Scott. Price is Right rules.
90s.
Price 2000s. Is Right rules. You both bust. No point. It's 89.
Yo, that was so close to the 90s, bro. That was like,
it's not the first. You won your off.
This is fun.
Is it a horror movie?
It is. No, it's not a horror movie, but I guess there's like horror elements. No, there's no horror elements. I guess some of the plot can be like horrifying, but you wouldn't call it a horror.
Is it a drama?
It is a drama.
Oh, but a point for
very
me?
Broadly, it's a drama, I guess.
Okay.
At least there's one main actor, and he's the one guy.
Is it like an actor, like a well-known actor, or just
very well-known actor?
Is it Nicolas Cage?
No, but I like the way you're thinking.
Is it Marlon Brando?
No, it's not the. Was he acting in '89 for like? Okay,
he's still alive. Yeah.
I'm not gonna say. When was the Godfather?
Like 70.
70? Okay.
3, 5.
Well, he would have probably cracked the pot by then. I mean, he died in the movie.
Well, at least he wasn't shitting himself.
Yeah.
I don't know much about Marlon Brando. So that doesn't.
He wasn't that old in the Godfather. He just had makeup.
Funny prosthetic.
Yeah.
I would love to do a Marlon Brando impression, and I think I know how to do it. You just get like the sort of tone of voice, but then just murmur because all he did was ever murmur.
You come to me at my daughter's wedding.
You sound like you're mumble rapping there.
He was the OG mumble rapper.
Lil Brando.
Right. Not Nick Cage, not Marlon Brando.
I just spat names. Do you want a hint?
Sure.
Is he the male or a female? Male. Or a non-binary?
Main actor.
It's not Stallone.
No. Oh god, how do I give hints?
Who is in the 80?
he cameoed as himself on The Simpsons.
Yeah. Mark Wahlberg.
No.
Mark Hamill?
No. Not a mark, I'm sorry to say.
Is it Arnold?
No, you have not hit the mark yet.
Jim Carrey.
I mean, if you were to say his initials, you would say thanks.
Thanks? In initials?
Tom Hanks.
Yes.
Oh.
This is probably an actual famous movie. People at home probably already know what this movie
is. Like,
Alright, it's a Tom Hanks movie. They're in the Burbs. The drama.
Does he get a point?
Yeah, he gets a point for that. Yes, point.
Yeah.
We got to say they got a point or not. I mean, if you guys don't know what the movie's about, let's walk through it.
Are there neighbors?
There are neighbors.
Are they having a disagreement?
I guess there's a few disagreements.
Or are they having a romance?
The main thing isn't the disagreement, and he is married.
It's an affair.
No,
it's not an affair.
Tom Hanks, what are you doing with your neighbors in the van?
Does Ray do anything with his wife? Yeah, he does. I guess they don't really.
Is there a murder?
There is a murder.
Holy shit.
Oh, is it like a murder mystery, bro?
It is a murder mystery. Oh. Points for both of you.
There we go.
All right.
That's why you said some elements are horrific, right?
Yeah.
And when was all the commie scares? Did that go into the late
80s?
McCarthyism?
Russia's the USSR is still there, so maybe.
I thought that McCarthyism was like the
50s. Yes, yeah,
but like Americans still hated Russia.
The Cold War wrapped up
in the 90s.
It was in the Cold War.
It's still in the forefront of people's minds back then.
Oh, so it's about the Cold War.
The murder, they're blaming it on the communists.
Pretty much.
Is this the plot of what's that? Hitchcock movie where they're looking through the window?
Oh, what's that movie called?
We all watched it.
We all watched it in school.
Through the window.
Through the window to the wall.
We reviewed it for our channel.
We literally did.
Well, the guy that looks through the window and calls people communists.
Yeah. Is that the name of the movie?
The guy who looks through the window and calls people communists. Sounds like a lo-fi track.
Is it window something?
Oh god.
Through the window.
Looking through the window. Opinions of the window.
Hitchcock.
Windows 10.
Window. Rear window.
It's not the front one. It's the rear one.
It's the rear one. Do they even have a front window? It's an apartment. It's all on the one side.
Well, apartments can have multiple sides. Depends this if your apartment's on the the edge.
I don't think his had one.
Actually,
either.
If this was a rear window, doesn't it imply there's another window other side for it to be rear?
Right? Or is it the rear of the building?
Oh, that's true. Anyways,
Mr. Fanks wakes up because there's strange noises in the suburban town of Hinckley Hills.
He's hearing Russian.
And the new next door neighbors, the Klopeks. Ah, there's a foreign name.
These damn immigrants.
All right, damn immigrants.
Where do you think they're from? Where do you think, which European country are they from?
Turkmenistan.
Russia?
No.
Yugoslavia?
No.
Is that a real place?
Serbia.
I mean, one of the quotes is literally, are they Slovaks? And then they're like, no.
Polish.
No. They're not Slovakian.
Czechoslovakian.
No.
I said
not, I just said they're not Slovaks.
So they speak racist?
Not. Yeah.
Oh, just like me. For real.
This is the this is the times of the Cold War.
It's all right to be racist to Eastern Europeans. It still is, debatably.
German.
Yes. German. Oh, points
but
to
they're
Jack.
East German, so they're communist.
Maybe. Let's establish some of the side characters as well. Lieutenant Mark Rumsfeld.
Okay, Mark Ruffalo.
Mark Ruffalo, yes. Played by Bruce Dern.
Bruce Willis.
Bruce. Who was a Vietnam veteran.
He was
veteran.
Not on Epstein's Island or was on Epstein's
Was he?
His name came up.
Damn.
I think we talked about this when we talked about Epstein.
I forgot.
Yeah. Anyway.
And then, relating to Mr. Mark, the next morning, one of the other neighbors, Walter, what does their dog do?
What's the dog doing? The dog's dead.
No.
The dog's found a dead body.
No.
Walter, I'm going to need you to walk the dog today, Walter.
Walter, the dog is like reporting to the Russians.
For the sake
Just like, what's that show?
It's also a bit of a comedy.
Stranger Things.
The dog's talking.
Sadly. I would love to see a talking
Mickey
dog.
It's Mickey Mouse's dog.
No, Pluto. The dog shits on Mark's lawn.
Damn.
Yeah.
And
what
then the Mark slips on it.
He dies.
Whoa,
yeah, sadly, shit. He hasn't died yet.
And that was the murder.
He does die.
I mean, there's some excellent plot points in here. This film seems like, Tom Hanks and another neighbor try to talk to the fucking
dog.
Not the dog.
They went, what the dog doing?
To the German people, but then they're attacked by bees.
Yo, this is the actor from The Beekeeper, bro. He's trying to
exactly
protect the hive.
Yeah. And they just spend that in most of the movie is just them trying to spy on this family, the seemingly innocent family.
Damn.
That and the only reason they have to suspect them is because there's noises coming from their house, and they are
domestic violence.
Mm-hmm. But so someone hasn't died up until this point.
Well, this is where, out of Mark, Walter, Ricky, and Art, who goes missing?
Art.
Walter. Walter no, goes Walter. Missing.
He broke a bed.
How do they know that Walter has gone missing?
Shit, Walter.
How do you,
because Walter has a dog.
The dog ate him.
Oh, I thought Walter was the dog, bro.
Oh, nah, he's the guy who stepped on the dog shit.
So that was Marky Mark.
No, Mark stepped on the dog shit.
Yeah, it was Mark.
Oh, then what the fuck? Walter is owning the dog.
Yeah, and the dog walked over. Just casually walks over.
So he gets missing, and I guess everyone's back the neighbors.
The Germans.
But it wasn't the neighbors.
It was not the neighbors.
It was actually...
the federal government.
They're not actually involved until the end. They're just doing like a citizen's investigation on all this.
Like we should do to find my wallet.
Mm.
Track him down.
Track him down.
It was the dog.
It was the dog.
It was the dog. Yeah, the dog wasn't fed.
So it ate Walter.
Well, Walter wasn't there to feed the dog. Otherwise, if the dog ate Walter, then it would be fed.
What happened to Walter?
It was art.
Keep in mind, strange noises.
Coming from the Germans.
Let's say it sounds like...
sex. That sounds like sex.
He buried himself.
So they suspect, point to you, they suspect that he was buried in the backyard.
Of the Germans' house.
Because... at night, he watches them digging in the backyard with pickaxes. Wait,
that's exactly what happens in the rear window. They see them digging. Is this a low-key soft reboot of rear window? Maybe it's inspired.
Maybe it is.
Hello. I have a suspicion that it is.
Mm-hmm.
This is them. I mean, the rest of the film is all just sort of like... it's a pretty long film, I would say. There's a shit ton of shit that happens. It eventually goes to them trying to find, like, bones. Right? They want to try to find human remains.
Wait, that's what they do in Rear Window.
Exactly.
They go and dig up the grave. Yeah.
But it was a flower pot.
Yes. It was a flower pot. But in this one, they're like, fuck it. They're going on a vacation. Let's sneak into their basement.
And what did they find? They find Walter.
Is he white?
White.
They Walter find... White.
Assume he's a white man.
I mean, they haven't found any remains.
They find the dog in the basement.
Is it something supernatural?
No.
Something sci-fi.
I would not say supernatural.
Real.
They find a Gorbachev like a nuclear hiding warhead in the basement.
They found my wallet.
See, you have to go into the movie and find your wallet.
I thought they found nothing and they were wrong.
Good thinking, but no. Because they want to hide the bodies, you know. How do you leave no evidence of no bodies?
So they did find something.
Yeah.
Okay, they found something.
They found the dog.
I already said
that.
What
the dog doing, right?
The dog's food. So that's why the dog is hungry.
It's not Walter. It's not the dog.
If you say that the dog is the food, then what would you use to make the dog food?
Soup.
What would you use to make the dog food?
Walter.
Yeah.
How do you cook the dog?
How do you cook the dog? Like make pans? Dog soup.
If you wanted to cook a dog,
an oven.
That could hide an oven. That could hide a body. What would you do
like
to a dead body?
Yeah,
a cremation furnace.
Oh.
Which oddly specifies 5,000 degrees.
Why would they own a cremation furnace?
Yeah, why would they? Who the fuck? Even if you're doing a murder, why would you own a cremation furnace?
In your furnace.
Yeah.
And then
I feel like they did the murders to justify owning that cremation furnace.
Or maybe they got it from like, you know, a lotto giveaway. It's like, oh, what should we do with this furnace, guys? How about we burn a body?
Shop. Maybe it's like a tax write-off. They're like, we gotta kill some people for this to be part of our job.
Yes, we've been using this. You see the ashes down there? You gotta check for bone samples. You can find Walter's bones right there.
So it was Walter?
No.
Did they find
not
a body?
Yet.
Nobody.
No
they found a cremation.
But they don't believe it, which is where the bad writing of this film begins to show itself to me. There's a cremation furnace, but they're still digging to look for bones, which confuses me.
Because there was no...
It was a red herring.
It was, I don't know. And then they keep digging and they hit a gas line and the house explodes.
And they all die?
No, they don't die.
Because they were outside.
No one dies. I love this line. A few minutes later, a disheveled Ray emerges from the flames.
It was Walter.
Just as his wife returns from dropping Dave at her sister's house.
Fucking Dave.
Fucking Dave.
So the German man burned up.
Well, I thought the Germans were away.
They came back.
Wait, so the Germans came back?
No.
No.
Who came back?
It was actually, yeah, the Germans do come back by this point. But they're just in the basement. Vacation. They're still in the basement digging a hole. And they hit a gas line.
And so they go out to get out of their car and then the house explodes?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
And then Ray emerges from the flames like the Terminator. Or like a phoenix.
Did anyone die in that explosion?
Nope. Obviously.
Walter did.
Walter.
He don't have his dead yet.
Yeah.
He's missing.
Apparently, Walter just has a medical problem.
Went on medicinal leave. Medical leave.
And so, you know.
No murder.
No murder.
That was dumb.
And the movie ends happily ever after.
Oh. Plot twist. It does not end there.
Oh. All right. Let me guess.
So.
They get arrested.
I'll give you a point for that. Ray's in the ambulance because the explosion was kind of crazy.
Yeah.
Is it? Yeah. And who joins them in the ambulance?
Walter.
No.
The German.
Yes, the Germans join him in the ambulance.
Oh, yeah. I mean, very burning, yeah.
Burning, man, yeah.
He just said some German. You got some German.
Yeah. At
this
point, they're still only neighbors.
Spicy flame.
Bratwurst? Bratgood.
Yeah, das ist gut.
Boost is good, yeah.
We destroyed this house like the Berlin Wall.
That hasn't happened yet.
That hasn't happened yet, but this is a prophecy. No,
actually, was it 89? I think it was 89.
89.
For the wall to go down.
Yeah.
But yeah, so... This guy's only been his neighbor this whole time. And now he's acting all friendly after he's just blown his house up. Yeah. So why did the German guy get into the ambulance?
To kill him.
Yes, point.
Oh. The real murder is happening.
Well, I mean, I guess he blew up his house, so like, I'd probably kill him too.
You could just made him pay for insurance.
Now, this is because Tom Hanks' character missed a key piece of evidence.
The furnace.
Other than the furnace.
The dog.
What were they looking for this whole time?
Bones.
Yes. They found there was a skull in the basement as well.
But they forgot to mention it.
No, they didn't find it.
What? They literally pulled that skull out of their ass.
You missed the skull in the basement.
And so the German guy went on the ambulance to cut his head off too.
Damn.
That came out of nowhere.
That did come out of nowhere. And guess who's driving?
Walter.
Not Walter.
Another German,
yeah.
It was a German plot all along.
And then they're all fighting in the ambulance, and the ambulance crashes into someone's house.
And when did the movie Die Hard come out?
Like 92.
Because... I don't know, was there like a big German thing there?
Yeah, German terrorists.
That was German terrorists.
They never hate Germans, do they, in those times?
Well, yeah, if you, I don't like, the film industry, Hollywood, like, they usually, like, pick a race to target or whatever.
Well, that's kind of topical, because Berlin Wall, right? Yeah. And they're like, these damn Eastern Germans.
Yeah.
Commie bastards.
Yeah. I'm gonna do a Die Hard.
Yeah. Do a Die Hard, and yeah, that's pretty much the movie.
Do we get to guess the IMDb score?
Yes.
It has a 5.2.
Price is Right rules.
So, like, what, five?
You have to guess it as close as you can, but not go over.
Oh.
I think it's probably 6.
6.8.
Damn, you get you that get point. Have you been counting the points? I think Jack has more points.
Yeah, I think Jack has more points.
Damn, really?
Now, this
win
movie.
This round.
Okay. I've got more to talk about in this movie because this, in 1988, this is very topical. What happened in 1988 that might, you know, cause this film to not be so good?
Reagan.
I say very topical because we've talked about it on the podcast a lot.
What happened in 1988? Chernobyl.
1988.
Like, not specifically what happened in 1988. We didn't talk about what happened in 1988, but we have talked about similar shit.
Well, we talk about a lot of shit
it's
in
pretty
this
weak.
Podcast.
Bro. We pretty much talk about it weekly.
Okay, movies. Films, movies.
Yeah.
But like a movie came out?
In the news segment. Two.
In the news segment.
What happens weekly in that weekly updates that might cause this film to be not so good?
Actor strike.
Close.
Writer's strike.
Ooh,
I'll give you a half a point for that one. All right. Because you said strike. So
yeah,
most of this film was actually improvised.
Yo, he improvised the entire ending.
Yeah, the cast line was a.
And one of the writers, they appeared in the film as a cameo, but they weren't allowed to contribute to the script while they were on set.
Yeah, that's the Deadpool 3 thing, right?
Oh.
Where like Ryan Reynolds couldn't ad lib anything because that would count as writing, and he's a writer.
Oh.
Damn, the union rules. But they get paid anyway because they're hired.
Oh yeah, Carrie Fisher is Tom Hanks's wife.
She's a pretty notable person, yeah, I'd say. Yeah,
she's dead.
Yeah, they kind of didn't do
rest
much.
In peace.
Yeah. But not know. In 1989. Oh yeah, Carl Weathers passed away.
Oh,
damn. Rest in peace, big man.
Indeed.
But yeah, that was a film.
Film.
Oh, also the good dog. Was the same dog that played Precious in The Silence of the Lambs.
Yo.
Classic.
Famous dog.
6 out of 10 movie. Should we watch this movie?
Maybe.
I think we know the entire plot now.
Yeah.
We do.
I've also pretty sure I fairly misrepresented it.
Damn, you lose all your points.
Fake news. Fake news. I lose all my points.
Shall we do another one?
Shall we do another one?
You got one more, right?
Yeah,
got one
right, more. Let's go.
Give it up.
All right, here we go. In the Name of the King, a dungeon siege tale.
Okay, it's a fantasy movie.
Mm-hmm.
It's David Bowie's elf movie.
In the same way that of David Bowie being like eccentric and odd, this movie it probably doesn't feel eccentric and odd, but I like the idea of it being odd. It's very odd in all of these things, and this one was one where I purposely tried to look for a bad rating.
Okay, all right, let's
this is like some low budget thing. Some like
it's not low budget, it's a pretty from what they say, it's a star-studded cast, even though I don't know most of these people.
Star-studded cast,
I mean,
is Kevin Costner in it?
I'm just going to give you a point for that because Kevin Costner is not in the film.
Oh, what?
But he was originally going to play the lead for it.
Holy shit.
Until... I need to look at the trivia section again. That was fucking nice, bro.
Yeah.
Where is it?
Can we guess the year?
Kevin Costner was offered the lead role, but he wasn't interested in filming a large-scale action film.
Okay, that's interesting because I'm trying to think about... But the reason I was thinking Kevin Costner, I was thinking of Waterworld, right?
Mm-hmm.
But he wasn't interested. So he'd either already done it, Waterworld, or he hasn't done it yet. So based on that, what year did Waterworld come out? That maybe we can figure out around there.
I don't know.
Is this the 2000s?
Yes.
Okay.
And since we've narrowed it down to 2000s, we need to get the specific year to get a point.
2006.
2002.
Closer.
Who's closer?
You.
Up or down? 2004.
Colder.
Yeah.
2005.
Warmer.
2008.
called?
2007.
Yeah, you said it at the same time. Point for both of you.
The golden year.
Who replaced Kevin Costner?
Who replaced Kevin Costner in 2007?
Kevin Spacey.
2007. Who was like doing shit in 2007?
Mark Wahlberg.
We watched him recently.
How recent? Like this year?
Yes.
Jason Statham.
Yes.
What?
Jason Statham as the lead role.
Oh, it is an action movie.
In a fantasy action movie. Now, this is not as hard as you think.
Who's
for
the
this
director?
Next one. Who's the director? I'll just tell you. It's U-Bowl. Or like U-B-O-L-L.
U-Bowl.
I don't know that guy.
No.
U-Bowl.
I don't think we know who he is either.
All right. It's interesting.
It's interesting. Your interests are perked.
Is this like the Conan the Barbarian for Jason Statham?
It kind of feels like that.
Because like that was Arnold's Conan the Barbarian fantasy action movie.
I don't know what Jason Statham
is. I don't know much about Conan. All I know is it's the video game, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Now, he didn't have a name in The Beekeeper, did he?
The Beekeeper.
Oh, no, he had an alias. But no one knows if that's his real name or not.
Yeah. John B.
In this movie, he does not have a name.
He's the protagonist.
He kind of is the protagonist, but he has a title, and it's his work title.
Knight.
No.
Lord.
Think beekeeper.
Beekeeper.
It's literally so similar to beekeeper.
The
this character.
Shepherd.
The chicken. Keeper.
Chicken keeper. Like dungeon master. You're closer. You just should go
the
closer
farmer.
The farmer.
Oh.
Jason Statham as the farmer.
Okay, he likes agriculture.
Yeah.
Which is funny, because there was a film recently called The Beekeeper, where he's the beekeeper.
Was he a farmer who had his farm destroyed?
Got raided by thugs.
I'll be honest, I did not read the plot of this too closely. It is fucking long and fucking there's so much shit.
Or is it a farmer who was there a prophecy at any point?
No,
his farm
is attacked. There you go.
Okay, his Why farm's attacked, and he's like, I gotta do something about that
by creatures called Krug.
Okay.
Ringo.
The Krugs.
He's been sent on a mission by Lord Farquaad to save the princess from the dragon slayer.
And the Krugs.
And the Krugs.
Well, is that a Lord of the Rings reference?
Lord of the Rings?
The movie?
The movie. Or The Hobbit. That reference.
What, me?
Dragon.
Am I what I'm referencing?
He's referencing Shrek.
Yeah. Oh, Shrek.
Yeah, that's right.
They didn't have a princess in Lord of the Rings.
Yeah, it doesn't Lord Farquaad, is that either?
Mm. Yeah, no Lord Farquaad.
So his farm gets attacked by these Krugs, I want revenge.
Revengeance.
Yeah.
What's the name of the movie again?
It's a big... What the fuck? In the Name of the King, a dungeon siege tale.
Well, I think he has to be he has to do something in the name of the king, right?
He has to go to Lord Farquaad.
So he goes to the king, maybe, and he's like, my farm got attacked? And the king's like, in the name of me, go out and defeat these Krugs.
You got one part of that, right? He does have to defeat the Krugs.
Okay, yes, he does have to defeat the Krugs.
Does he go to the king?
I don't know if he goes to the king. Yeah, he does go to the king, but... I missed one thing. His wife and son are out of town to sell vegetables.
And they get killed.
The son gets killed. The wife...
is captured.
Yes.
Oh my god, this is Shrek. He has to go rescue his...
Point.
Wife. Donkey.
I don't think there is a donkey.
His son is the donkey.
Yeah.
Son's a donkey, mate.
But yeah. And his friend, Norik, played by Ron Perlman...
Ron DeSantis.
Do you guys know him?
Yeah, Ron Perlman is known for... Well, he's in a bunch of things, but notably, I know him for Payday 2. That's where I first saw him, I think. But he's in a bunch of things, yeah. I don't know, he reminds of Nathan Fillion for some reason.
Mm.
In the type of role... He's just a random role, so I know.
Is Eddie Murphy in this film?
I don't think Eddie Murphy is in this film, sadly.
Sad.
Okay, yeah. So his family has killed his wife, it's captured, and his farm's destroyed, and he goes to the king.
He does eventually meet the king, I think, yeah. Oh god, this movie is just so convoluted.
Does the king
dumb.
Send him on a quest?
The king does send him on a quest?
He tells him to fuck off.
To save his wife.
Yeah. Hmm.
And he...
Then... The king's Magus. Merrick.
Mages Magus.
M-A-G-U-S.
Magus.
Magus.
Magus. The king's Magus.
M-A-G-U-S.
It seemed that Merrick comes to know something special about Farmer. He meets Farmer and tells him that the king needs him more than he realizes.
I need you to keep farming for free. Because that's feudalism, baby.
It is feudalism.
So, do you think the farmer follows the king or says, fuck you?
Says, fuck you.
Aye, aye, captain.
Yeah, no, he says, fuck you to the king.
This is ain't about authority.
Because why? He gotta find his wife, man.
But he's doing it in the name of the king. The title says in the name of the king. It doesn't make sense.
No.
What is his title? It was just a randomly procedurally generated title.
I mean, there's just so much.
Make me fantasy movie. Reference king.
Farmer, along with his two friends, are passing through a seemingly dangerous Cedric Forest.
It was Cedric.
It's not Cedric Diggory.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking of.
Oh, and then some forest nymphs hang them upside down.
Yo, nymphos.
Okay.
Okay.
Thanks. And then they just let them go to tell them to go away and never come back.
Farming.
Is this plot guessable?
Is this plot guessable? I don't know. So I'm just not gonna let you guys get.
He's on a journey like a Lord of the Rings.
In the general
terms,
he's going on this Lord of the Rings journey, I guess. Yeah. And he finds his wife.
He finds his wife.
He meets kills funny the creatures.
His pregnant wife.
Friends.
Impregnated by the Krugs?
No, well, they just happen to be pregnant, I guess.
By a separate man.
It was Immaculate Conception.
Ooh, yes. It was in the name of the king, bruh. The king did it.
In the name of the king.
The Krugs.
Refuse to let her go.
The Krugs are controlled by a big wizard.
Oh, Sauron. That's the Magus of the king.
No, or the fucking Count Dooku in Lord of the Rings.
Pretty much. Pretty much.
Who?
Count Dooku.
Count Dooku's in Star Wars. You're thinking of Lord Saruman.
Yeah, I forgot his name, so I called him Count Dooku.
Oh, wait, he is the same actor. I forgot, yeah.
I mean, there's even, like, a big battle.
Because he controls the funny trolls.
He also fought in World War II, fun fact.
Oh.
He eventually has to go back to the king because the king needs him to fight in a war
in
against the Krugs.
Oh, conscription, baby.
Wait, so he gets his wife back first?
No. He only gets his wife back at the end of the movie.
Oh. Wait, so he goes on this quest, and what, he just abandons this quest in the middle and comes back to the king?
Because he can't find the Krugs.
I guess because he realizes the king will help him.
The king realizes
that he is indeed his lost son, when Farmer quotes a line that king used to tell his son every night.
So the king is the farmer's son.
I guess.
Dang.
I didn't even read that.
Wait, is it not the farmer,
not
the king's
it's
son?
Not the other, it's another son that he lost ages ago.
It's his side bitch's son.
So, is the farmer the rightful king? Is that going to be a plot point?
Well, the farmer is only the king's father.
He's not royalty.
He would be royalty. What? How did the king... the king got adopted into this family?
He's a bastard child.
But is he a bastard... He's not a...
This is the king.
Huh?
Maybe the king was a bastard child. He got adopted by the royal family. And then the old king died.
Yeah, it's an adoption thing, I guess. Yeah.
Probably.
Anyway, that's...
Unlikely allies. Who allies with the farmer...
To defeat the Krugs.
To defeat the Krugs.
The Magus.
No. The Magus actually dies.
The forest nymph.
Yes!
Holy shit. Point.
Oh, they're like the Ewoks.
Yes.
Yeah.
They join the army to fight against the Krugs while Farmer leads a small team.
Of farmers.
Not farmers.
A fellowship, some would say.
Pretty much.
I mean,
it's
conscripted, so I guess other knight.
Because they sneak in to a kill ragtag group the, of knights. The big wizard guy.
Saruman.
Saruman.
I'm just going to skip all this. Saruman we're at the end like of the Pokemon film by now.
All right, we're in the third act.
At end of this is the ending scene, I think.
Does he fight the dragon?
He gets his wife.
He gets his wife. The main guy is killed. What does he say to his wife?
I love you.
Literally, he says, "I love you."
Is that in the plot description?
Farmer finally confesses his love for Solana verbally.
Oh, he doesn't.
Which he had never done before. He does an emotional act until the end.
That's a Jason Statham move right there.
He goes, "Well, how do you do Jason Statham voice?" Yeah. Oh, I love you.
What? And you know what?
I love you.
I think I love you.
Radio. Let's go beat up some criminal.
I'm what they call a beekeeper.
I'm what they call a wife lover.
And I love my wife.
I love her wife. It has awards.
We won an award.
Picture of 2007.
Hessian Film Award.
That's not a real award. Get that out of here.
Leo Awards.
For all the Leos in the world.
And the Razzie Awards.
Well, Razzie. That's a shit award. That's like the one which they go, oh, we hate movies. These are bad movies.
It is. Now, I don't know German, so I can't tell you what the Hessian Film Award is for, but it was given to the producer.
Right. What's the German bit?
Ehrenpreis? There's Hessischen Ministerpräsidenten. So I guess that's president.
Something given by president.
So I don't know. Maybe. I don't know.
The president the president's of the award. Award. Maybe.
Is that just presidency?
I guess whoever the
president is. It was the president's name.
Well, it's not the German president because they don't have one. Probably the association of
whatever. It would have been the
can I be bothered the president to find out no we're moving on the Leo Awards. What did they actually win? And keep in mind this is
nothing.
They did have three awards, but this is hilarious because it's like three awards in a feature-length drama, which just sounds like a tiny category just made to give them drama. Awards
that's just the drama category.
Is it?
Feature-length just means movie.
Oh, okay.
Not short film.
Movie.
So it's just movie.
What did they win?
Movie so they, drama.
How big production.
They won.
They won three awards?
Not just nomination?
Yes.
Okay.
Oh, there is one nomination, two wins.
Okay.
What's the second one?
I reckon what? Costume.
Yes, they won best costume design.
And you said feature film drama award.
Yeah, all three of them. All three of the awards are for feature-length dramas within that, yeah.
Costume and visual effect.
Not specifically visual
action.
Effects.
Action.
No.
Production.
Production design. Picture editing was nominated.
Picture editing.
Damn, I guess they got Jason Statham in a nice bald cap.
Doesn't need a bowl cap.
Need a bowl cap, no sir. And then they just have like five things at the Razzie Awards.
Yeah, but
all nominees, but one winner.
Best Jason Statham movie of 2007.
Quite the opposite.
The worst Jason Statham movie.
Worst picture, worst supporting actress, worst supporting actor, worst screenplay, and they won worst director.
Very sad.
But also fuck the Razzies.
Fuck the Razzies.
But they razzed up though.
Did they though?
Did they razz up Lena Dunham and Baby Gronk?
With the Kai Cenat in a hire?
And they got text like Kai Cenat.
The you mean Phantom Tech?
Yeah.
Both that's pretty skibbity, bro.
How long do you think the script development took?
2 weeks.
6 months.
I'll give it to him then. A year.
Dang.
Because he had to rewrite 80% of the script. Why did they have to rewrite 80% of the script?
Because it was the exact script. Oh, writer's strike.
No.
No, wait, hold on. That's the stuff that I...
Yeah.
The global financial crisis.
No.
Then that was the year after.
Was it because of a world event?
9/11 too.
They just too similar to another script?
Because they read The Wizard of Oz.
What came out in 2000?
Well, just too similar to...
They watched Shrek. That was 2006.
We've mentioned it already.
Lord of the Rings.
Yeah. Too similar to the Lord of the Rings trilogy.
No, it's not.
It's not really.
Because they rewrote it after it was too similar.
Okay, it was, yeah.
Well, I mean, I guess Saruman.
And having a small team to go in.
This is every fantasy
big army story. Fantasy armies fighting.
With a party, you know.
No, that's not every fantasy story. That's not Game of Thrones.
Don't they have
everyone
parties?
Hates each other, bro. The beef.
True.
Except when they team up to fight the White Walkers, but that...
Yeah.
That's besides.
Because they're all racist in that world.
It's basically the real world.
It's the real world.
That's bad. Okay, should we guess the IMDb score?
I've got a few more trivia stuff that it's touch on. Actually, the King's personal guards had the stunt team of I don't know how to pronounce his name, but he did a bunch of like the old Chinese like
fight sword.
Yeah. Those films where there's like the swords and like it's all flashy and they fly around everywhere. What do you call that?
A wire work.
Because we watched Crouching Tiger.
There's a term for
Hidden
it.
Dragon. Yeah. Wuxia.
Yep. Martial arts.
Wuxia films. Who got paid more, the director or that guy?
Jason Statham.
Director?
No, the director was paid less than the stunt team that they hired.
Get wrecked. I mean, I guess the stunts better be good.
Maybe the director like just did not want to be there.
Maybe.
I would want to be there.
You would want to be there, wouldn't you?
Yeah, I would.
You would.
Just be like, hey.
I mean, the director did do something. He did end up doing something good. Would you call method acting like if you give them like something shitty to drink and then they have to respond by acting shittily because they drank something really shitty in real life rather than acting? Is that method acting?
Oh, well, firstly, fuck method acting. Just act normally. Secondly,
that's not acting, bro.
What do you mean?
You're acting normally, you're not acting.
No, I mean like, you know those fucking pretentious ass actors who are like, who just act like a dick because they're like, oh, it's method acting. Jared Leto. Okay, let's look at Jared Leto as a case study.
Morbius, bro. That was so cool.
He did, but like he was like being weird when he was the Joker or whatever and treating people weird. Bro, just don't. Like, can't you just act, bro? Just act like... You know those actors who, like, you know Jennifer Lawrence, right? She's pretty open about the fact that, like, she's just Jennifer Lawrence, but when the camera, when it's, like, action, she acts, and then after they say cut, she's just normal. Like, you know what I mean? Isn't that what acting is? Anyway, sorry, that's besides the point. But anyway, method acting is dumb. That's my point.
You're immersing yourself in the character, bruh.
Immersion? More like... Jason Statham has to drink tea.
Yeah, Morbius. I can't. Like, he's something about his wheelchair or something, right? How he's like, I can't
imagine myself being.
I have to be in a wheelchair at all times on set, and he like held up stuff like production because he wanted to be in the wheelchair, and they're like, get up and like go do this something. Like, nah, I'm in a wheelchair, bro. Yeah, that's crazy.
I just want to push my wheelchair.
Funny. Fuck Jared.
The director, there's a scene where Jason has to drink some medicine. He was given tea. What did they mix the tea with?
Piss.
No.
With medicine, you said?
Like a type to of pretend medicine. To be medicine. They're acting like it's medicine, but it's just tea mixed with something, thanks to the director.
Engine oil.
Coffee.
Safe to eat. Tea and coffee is a thing. Coffee TM.
Oh, true.
Tea and...
Freaking milk. Malaysians.
Milk.
Yeah, fuck you. Don't drink tea with your milk with your tea. Drink it black.
They put actual medicine in there.
No.
Poison.
No.
Rat poison.
They put a bit of vinegar.
You might put vinegar on chips. You might put this.
Salt. Pepper.
No.
Sugar.
Mustard.
What do you put on chips, bro? Tomato sauce?
Yes. I like how you said everything except ketchup.
Ketchup?
Yeah. Does anyone actually put mustard on chips?
Yeah.
Unless it's like just mustard.
I'm thinking like loaded chips. So
yeah. Just mustard?
Nah, probably not.
No, they don't usually serve mustard.
To be fair, I would eat a mustard sandwich.
You would?
Yeah.
Mustard
on bread?
Wait, not just mustard and bread though, right?
No, I would enjoy mustard and sandwich. That's just mustard and bread.
Yeah.
Yes, really.
Maybe some pickled radishes. Oh.
That's extra sour, bruh. Don't think I can handle that much mustard in my life. Because it's already stinky as it is.
I don't know. I would eat mayonnaise pickle sandwich.
That's tamer than all out mustard and pickles.
Mustard and pickled is a good combination. I know that. We serve mustard and pickle burger.
Yes.
So just mustard and pickles?
No. Obviously it has other things, but like it's called the mustard and pickle. Because it has mustard and pickle.
Sounds like a good time out.
Though most, I guess not most, but the cheeseburgers, they have mustard and pickles in them.
What cheese? Oh, okay, here's the one thing I don't said. What is a cheeseburger?
It's a burger with cheese.
Because no places really have a cheeseburger. It's like, that's an American thing.
Yes.
You know how many fucking dumb Americans walk into the place and go, can I have a cheeseburger? I'm like, shut the fuck up and sit down and read the menu.
Now I want to talk to
you. You know, I got a man yelled at me the other day because I was hosting, so I was like, oh, I'll take you to your table. Here's a menu, have a read. And then he was like, oh, he like waved at me and I came over. I'm like, hey, how's it going? And he's like, I want to order now. And it's like, oh yeah, you just use the QR code. And he got so mad at me before you use the QR code.
Fuck the QR code, mate.
And I was like, oh, if you don't want to do that, you can just come up to the counter. He's like, grr, why did you sit me at a table then? I'm like,
actually, that's a fair point. That's a fair point.
That is not a fair point.
Because most places have waiters to take the order.
It's not a restaurant. We're not a restaurant. Hey, it's fast food.
Why'd you sit us down?
It's just part of the service.
See, bad service.
What the fuck do you mean?
I'm agreeing with that man.
No, that man like lost his shit. That's my role. I was the host. Yeah, what do you think the host is supposed to do?
Yeah, I'm not sure. Just
ignore
you.
Everyone
I'm
that comes
on
in.
On the grilled protocol of sitting you down.
Well, no, because it's pretty clear, right? Because we have a limited amount of tables. You sit people at table. It's not like, because we get bookings and shit. This isn't like, I don't know, an empty restaurant. You know, like, see. It's
yet,
like, you know,
the
you
restaurants
know when you go into...
also have limited tables.
Yeah, so you come in and I get you a table if you're dining in.
Yeah.
So then you have a table.
And then the waiter comes.
And you
order.
Like, you probably don't want to just stand there at the front of the line with a menu not sure what you want.
Also,
you decide before you go.
He already sat down, so he doesn't want to go back.
Yeah, and then that's what the QR code's for, and he's paying by card as well.
But he's like, fuck the QR code. This is a free country. I don't want to fucking use the QR code, mate.
Well, then he can come up to the counter. He has options. He literally has choice.
Fuck you. That's probably what he's thinking.
Nah. You don't defend this man. This man was a cunt. And then he also just, you know, so I gave him a table, right? And then he just changed his table anyway. So the point being is, we need to know where you guys are so we can bring you your food. Because we are waiters. Like, we do bring your food up to you. Food. The only thing we don't do is, like, take your order at the table. Which is like, that's not an unheard of thing. I went to a fancy restaurant in South Bank where you only ordered from the QR code.
See, bad restaurant.
Well, that was like a actual fancy like restaurant. That was like, meals are like $40. It was like, the creme de la creme, you know?
They're just trying to charge you on that QR code tax, bruh.
Yeah. Besides the point, shut the fuck up, sit down, look at your menu. I don't remember where this came from.
This came from burgers. Oh,
cheeseburgers.
Mustard and pickle sandwiches. Yummy. I would have loved me some. Anyways, speaking of choices, the director claims by himself that he had to fire several CGI providers.
Do you count cheeseburgers as having like salad in it?
Like a lettuce?
Like lettuce, tomato, onion, like a basic salad?
Most of the time, no.
Because I the only place I think that doesn't do that is, like, Mac is the one that does just, because they don't have any, salad. They don't really do that.
The Big Macs have lettuce.
Yeah, only Big Mac have lettuce, and that's just really basic.
And then they have the, like, what, deluxe things.
Oh, yeah.
But like, most, from what like, I know in America,
like your
joints,
Betty's Burgers and the other stuff, they all come with salad, right? It's like a pretty
in the burger.
Unless... Hungry Jack's has salad as well, right?
Yeah. But then the cheeseburger is
just
ketchup, mustard, pickle.
Yeah.
And cheese.
Which is, I guess that's what I would say is a cheeseburger, but that's also just because Macca's and...
What do you call, like, a regular burger then? Like a beef burger? Would you just call it a beef burger?
Yeah, with... in a typical not Macca's burger joint, yeah, there would be a beef burger with the with your vegetables in there and no cheese, unless specified, I suppose.
See, this is something I don't think about. If you think of, like, if you make a Whopper at home, it feels just like the kind of one of those, like, backyard grill things that you do, because you have ketchup, lettuce, tomato, onion, pickle, and that's, like, a the basic standard breakfast burger. Backyard burger.
That, in my mind, that's what I associate a regular burger with. Yeah. I don't know.
I guess the American standard of a cheeseburger is burger, no lettuce or salad, and
is cheese. It just generally because they're unhealthier? Like, that's maybe,
unbalanced.
Veggies. I want my cheese.
I feel like the salad, like, makes, it's a pretty big part of the burger, I feel
it
like.
It completes
like,
the deal.
It also adds to, like, the crunch factor and, like, the juiciness a bit.
Maybe we're just Aussie.
Yeah.
Let's go out and get some Aussie burgers.
And even if you, like, mess up the meat a bit, the juices and stuff of the salad can help with that if you want your meat to feel a bit juicy, even though it might not be.
It's not meat juice.
It's not meat juice. No, no. There's a nice blend, there's a taste profile, I don't fucking know,
We don't want a cheeseburger, mate.
Cheeseburger, you can make that at home. Get it from fucking Woolies.
Or you can just get the burger and get rid of the salad. And not eat it like a baby. Have I told you guys about a guy I know who deconstructs his burgers? When he orders
one? Yeah, I think he's always.
Yeah.
Well, you can just come to grill, that we'll do it for you.
Yeah, just don't build the burger. Just put the ingredients on the plate.
We have an option of no bun.
Just patty.
Just patty and salad sauce.
Yeah. When we have no bun, we put it in like a box and make it like a salad.
Yeah, that's what we put in a salad bowl. Mm.
Beef Caesar salad.
Yeah, pretty much. Can we go back to the film?
Yeah.
No more burger.
Burger tangent. Burger tangent burger over.
Tangent, yeah.
I kind of want burgers now.
A grill trip. I'm going to grill.
Oh, there is a director's cut. Obviously, how much longer?
6 minutes.
2 minutes.
I'm just going to give you guys another guess. The film is 2 hours 7 minutes.
And now it's 3 hours.
10 minutes.
34 minutes longer. I'll give 34. That one to you.
It's actually longer.
Yeah. Mm,
13 new scenes. So that's another way you can tell it was crazy. It's kind of bad.
It is the Lord.
Production of the CGI was convoluted and problematic. Why did the director have to fire several CGI providers?
They kept adding hair to Jason Statham's head.
Yeah.
2007, he had more hair back then.
Probably.
There's a buzz cut in the film.
He's still bald to me.
They were outsourcing their CGI jobs to lower quality studios.
They just weren't doing a good job.
Yeah. Film, it's kind of dumb.
Shall we guess the IMDb score and call it a day?
Yes, sir.
I reckon it is a lovely 1.8.
I think it's a solid 5.
Price is Right rules. He gets it 3.8 somehow.
Damn. It's not one.
It's not two.
Do you think we should watch this movie? Closer. Price is Right rules, whatever. So if it's over, it's
over.
Bad. We should watch this one.
We should watch Price is Right.
Yes.
2 hours would be better spent watching Price is Right.
Yeah. Anyway, that was a fun game. Who won?
Jack won. Yeah.
Ooh, party. Yeah.
No.
He's fudging the numbers. Very fudging the numbers.
I'm watching the numbers tick up.
All right. Anyway, that was a little bit of fun. Let us know if you like this format. We might do it more in the future. Next week, we'll be covering the film Argyle and the TV series Mr. and Mrs. Smith.
Smithy.
So stay tuned for that one. Check us out on Spotify, Apple Podcasts.
Yo.
You can also hit us up on unholy.pod@gmail.com.
Mm-hmm.
No, sorry, 3unholythings@gmail.com. Mm-hmm. Unholy.pod on Instagram and TikTok.
Yes.
And let us know what's going on with you.
What's going on?
Yeah.
What
do you like on your burgers?
I like
all mustard, no patty, and pickles.
He gets it.
You should try to order that at Grill.
I should.
You can, I can do it for you.
Might be a waste of money, but sure.
Just for you, I would subtract all of the items so you'd save money. You know what I mean? Normally what you do is, he'd go... Oh, actually, I'm just revealing company secrets, am I?
They're trying to grab more money off
you. All right.
Cut the tape.
We'll see you guys later. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Yeah.